Yep.
Our talent preliminary winner and recipient of a $500 cash scholarship is Miss University Abigail Church.
Our red carpet evening wear preliminary winner and recipient of a $400 cash scholarship is Miss Jones County Carson Ulmer.
Congratulations, ladies. You may make your walk.
All right, don't forget, you gotta join us again tomorrow night.
It is unreal, to say the least. I absolutely love to dance. It's not just a passion for me, not just a hobby, it's a way of life. It's a way for me to express myself and just really feel at home on a stage. And winning a talent preliminary at Miss Mississippi is such an honor. Every single girl in my group has such a unique gift and a unique talent where they got the opportunity to shine tonight. And they're all absolutely amazing. So I'm just feeling so blessed and so honored to be given this award tonight.
Baby, baby, baby. Ooh, I love you, my oh my. Yeah, river deep, mountain high, high, high. If I lost you, would I cry?
Miss Jones County, Carson Ulmer. And her bells, Mackenzie Olson, Cora Mae McKinnon, and Amaya Jamise Marie Walker. Thank you, ladies.
It feels absolutely amazing. I'm so thankful. I just felt so confident. You know, you put on a piece of clothing and sometimes you're like, I don't feel too good in this, but when I put the dress on, I just felt so confident. It was kind of like I felt a sense of peace.
It has been absolutely amazing. This is my fourth time to compete, and every year it's just amazing getting to see all the ladies, the board, the volunteers. It's just an amazing experience, and that's why I keep coming back.
It has been wonderful. Just the girls, we all come across the state in one place. These are women that are educated, that have things that they're passionate about, and it's just been a wonderful week so far.
It has been so much fun. This is my fourth year competing, and we always have such a good time here, but I can tell you for a fact, this is the best group of girls that I've ever had the pleasure of competing against. We have all bonded and had the best time together. We stay laughing and talking and just really hyping each other up. So I've had the best time because of them.
It has been absolutely incredible. This is my fourth time to be here at Miss Mississippi, and every single time I leave with a new best friend, a new set of skills, a newfound confidence in myself. And I know a lot of the girls can say the same thing, but those are the things that keep me coming back.
Our talent preliminary winner and recipient of a $500 cash scholarship is Miss Riverbend, Kayla Braswell.
And our red carpet preliminary winner and recipient of a $400 cash scholarship is Miss Mississippi State University, Emmy Perkins.
Congratulations, ladies. Please go ahead and take your walk.
Don't forget to join us again tomorrow night as we continue on this journey to the crown of Miss Mississippi 2022.
I feel on cloud nine right now. I did not think this was gonna happen, but I'm so grateful it did, and I just really wanna thank God.
What went through your mind when you heard your name called?
Oh my God, I won a preliminary talent at Miss Mississippi. This is my first ever shot at Miss Mississippi, so I'm just in absolute awe.
Well, tell us a little bit about that talent and why you chose it.
So I just graduated 3 weeks ago from the Mississippi School of the Arts, and I was trying to figure out what song I wanted to do for a competition that my school was competing in, and one of my teachers came up to me and said, I think this song would sound beautiful with your voice. So I went back to my room, learned it, fell in love with it, and knew this is what I wanted to compete with, and I've been competing with it in competitions, and I knew this was the song for me for Miss Mississippi.
But we
Miss Mississippi State University, Emmy Perkins. And her bells, Addison Reese Hardaway, Lindley Reese King, and Olivia Grace Lee. Thank you, ladies.
Wow, is what I feel. I'm at a loss for words, and I'm honestly just so incredibly grateful to be standing where I am right now.
Well, what ran through your mind when they called your name?
Complete shock, but also a sense of gratitude because, you know, I'm only 5'1", and I've always lacked a confidence in myself when it came to things like modeling and evening wear. And the great thing about this organization is that it's not about what you look like on the outside, and I want to spread that message to young girls. I'm 5'1", but I'm confident, and that's what sets people apart.
Oh, it has been so fun. I've been so calm. The girls are amazing, and I've just been having the time of my life.
Why did you choose to do pageants?
It was something that I had always watched and been interested in, but it was really when I came about 5 years ago, my mom actually sent me a memory today of when we came 5 years ago, that I was like, I want to be on that stage, and here I am.
Miss Mississippi has been the funnest week that I've had in the past 4 years. I've developed new friendships, and I've learned a lot about these girls and also about myself. Being the 31st contestant, I have a room to myself, and it's given me the opportunity without a phone, and even, well, when I say without a phone, we had bad service in the hotel, so without a phone, I've learned a lot about myself and what I'm capable of, and I cherish that, and I hope to take it with me in the future.
I have absolutely loved my entire time here at Miss Mississippi. These are some of the kindest, most genuine women I've ever been had the privilege of being a part of, and I'm just really excited to see how the week turns out.
I am feeling fantastic. I just performed my talent piece. I am so thrilled with how it went, and everybody this week has just been absolutely incredible. We had so much fun backstage tonight, so I'm on cloud nine.
Well, I know that we wouldn't get a lot of sleep, and I can attest to that. That is very true, but I have made friendships already that I know I will keep for a lifetime, and I have worked on myself a lot, and I just really enjoy it here.
Before we announce tonight's winners, let's welcome back to the stage your reigning Miss Mississippi, Holly Brand, once again, ladies and gentlemen. And presenting tonight's awards are Jennifer Tilliston and Carlos Latore.
Okay, our talent preliminary winner and recipient of a $500 cash scholarship is Miss Leaf River Valley, Charity Lockridge.
And our red carpet Red Carpet Preliminary winner and recipient of a $400 cash scholarship is Miss Midtown Point, Connor Dowdo.
Congratulations, ladies. You may take your walk.
Don't forget to join us again tomorrow night for the conclusion of this journey to the crown of Miss Mississippi 2022.
It feels unbelievable, but most importantly, I have to give all the glory to, and honor to God, because He did this and I allowed Him to speak through me tonight to minister to the crowd.
Well, tell us a little bit about the song you sung and why you sung it.
I sang Listen off of Dreamgirls. My dad chose the song for me actually a few years ago, but this year I had the opportunity to reserve that spot first, so I sang it. I switched my talent, but that song has more of a meaning to it for me. That song is me telling my story, telling that I'm brave, I have a story to tell, and I want people to listen. And as I got out there today, I see that I captivated the attention of thousands, and I couldn't ask for any more. I thank you, and I hope to give God all the glory and hope that people see that it was Him shining through me.
You see, I'm done believing you. You don't know what I'm feeling. I'm more than what you made of me. I followed the voice you think you gave to me. But now I gotta find my own. Now I have to find my own.
Miss Midtown Point, Connor Dowdell. And her bells, Madeline Ruth Crosby, Georgia McKee Davis, and Molly Pace Holloman. Thank you, ladies.
I am so thrilled. It's such an indescribable feeling just to be even on the stage, let alone win a preliminary, my first try.
Wow. Well, tell us, what did you think? What ran through your mind when your name was called?
I just started crying. I'm not even gonna lie, I started crying. I looked at my dad. My dad does not cry, y'all. Like, he does not cry, he doesn't do anything, but he had tears in his eyes and that made me cry. And I just felt like $1 million.
My year has been an absolute dream come true. I've accomplished everything that I wanted to accomplish. I've been able to partner with the Mississippi Commission for Volunteer Service and Governor Tate Reeves and First Lady Ely Reeves to implement the first Mississippi Serves Day. I've traveled over 32,000 miles just in the state of Mississippi. I went through 7 cars. I competed for the job of Miss America, made a ton of new friends, and I've won over $20,000 in cash scholarships. So it has been such a blessing to serve as Miss Mississippi. I'm very sad to see it come to an end, but I'm very excited for our next Miss Mississippi.
You know, when you started on your journey years ago, did you ever think it would end like this?
Absolutely not. I've always dreamed of being in this position, but I went through a phase after the first year that I competed not thinking that I was good enough to ever be in this position, and kind of lost my confidence there for a little while, but I got it back. And last year I told the girls today, I said, you know, I was just there for me. I wasn't there for anybody else. Every phase of competition, I was truly had an audience of one, and it was just between me and the Lord, and I was just there to prove to myself that I could do it. And winning was the cherry on top, but I knew I had plenty of time to compete if it didn't end that way.
And here to present flowers to your third alternate receiving a $3,000 scholarship are Rusty Larson, owner of Rusty's Riverfront Grill, along with his daughter Olivia Larson, and Winky Freeman, board member of the Miss Mississippi Corporation.
So we'll start with the fourth alternate is Miss All-America City, Kaylin Costello.
And your third alternate is Caitlin Perry, Miss Gulf Coast.
Presenting flowers to your second alternate, who receives a $5,000 scholarship, are David and Catherine McCray and Jenny Simmons of Simmons Erosion Control. Our second alternate is Miss Hattiesburg, Vivian O'Neill.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we are down to the final two. And here to present flowers to your first alternate are Johnny Lee Reynolds Sr., representing the Vicksburg Convention Center and Visitors Bureau, and Katie Hedgeland, representing Bank Plus. The first alternate will receive a $7,500 scholarship provided by the Miss Mississippi Corporation.
Okay, and also here to help us crown your Miss Mississippi 2022 is Maureen Wasilowski, Vice President and General Manager of Ameristar Casino Hotel, Mayor George Flags Jr., David Blackledge, the Executive Director of Miss Mississippi Corporation, and Cameron Davis, Miss Mississippi's Outstanding Team 2022. Miss Mississippi 2022 will receive a $10,000 scholarship provided by Ameristar Casino and Hotel. And if for any reason the winner is unable to fulfill her duties or is crowned Miss America, our first alternate will assume the responsibilities of Miss Mississippi 2022.
All right.
So, are we ready? Our first alternate is Miss Leaf River Valley Charity Lockridge.
That means that Miss Mississippi 2022 is Emmy Perkins. Give it up for your candidates. Delicate process.
Congratulations, Emmy. Please take your first walk as Miss Mississippi.
Thank you all so much for joining us for Miss Mississippi 2022.
I feel thankful. You know, God has blessed me with this incredible opportunity, and I'm ready to run with it. It initially was shock, but now I'm just so ready to take on this role.
Well, when you were standing up there, and it was just the two of you at the end, first runner-up and you, what was running through your mind?
So Charity Lockridge is one of my best friends, and I met her doing this system of Miss Mississippi. And so, you know, to stand there with somebody that you're such good friends with and know that no matter what the outcome was, the state's in great hands, was just a peace and understanding. We both talked about how at peace we felt in that moment.
That's wonderful. Tell us a little bit about Emmy. Who are you, your family, and things that you want the state of Mississippi to know about you?
So I'm a 21-year-old from Hattiesburg, Mississippi. I have a 16-year-old sister and two incredible parents. And then we name all of our pets off Gilligan's Island. So we're growing an island here. But my family and my friends are my world. I love music and the arts, and they make my world go round. And when I discovered my love for the arts in the fourth grade, I ran with it. And that's what I want to promote to the world. That's what I want people to see when they see me. Authenticity, music, and a love for this state.
Tell us whatever brought you into the Miss Mississippi system.
The scholarship opportunity. You know, I had a challenge to myself, get through school completely debt-free. And today, standing on the stage, I not only can say that I've completed my undergrad debt-free because of this organization, I can get my higher education degree and do the same thing.
Wow. What made you think that when you came into this competition that you had it all, that you could bring home the crown?
I had a sense of calming presence from the Lord, and I think it only comes from Him. And I'd prepared, I'd done everything I needed to do, and so this week was just a chance to play out all the stuff that I'd prepared on stage and enjoy the moment.
Anything, if you got no one to tell them to, it's true. I was made for you.
State University, Emmy Perkins. And her bells, Addison Reese Hardaway, Lindley Reese King, and Olivia Grace Lee. Thank you, ladies.
Emmy, some say that text messaging impairs young people's ability to have conversations with proper spelling and grammar. Do you think this is true?
I have a 16-year-old sister who has a cell phone at her fingertips. She uses it all the time, and that's become what our generation does. And so I think we need to focus on the ability to teach kids what's important in today's world, and we can do that through smartphone apps. I use an app called Flipgrid with Music as Medicine to empower students and educate them on music and the arts. So we can use technology for the better. Thank you.
Thank you.
Wow, Charity, you just placed first runner-up at Miss Mississippi. How are you feeling right now?
Emotional. I'm really emotional right now. I can't stop crying because I cannot believe how far God has brought me from starting my first year 4 years ago and not making the top 10, not even making the top 15, to the growth that he's put into me. It's just amazing.
Well, it is just amazing to see you up here and all the talent that you have. Tell us, how have you grown over the years by participating in Miss Mississippi?
My communication skills, number one, though, my communication skills have grown tremendously. And not only that, I've learned how to serve people with selflessness. And before, we always had the agenda to serve being in the Miss America organization, but doing it willingly, it's different.
Tell us, what about this organization drew you to it in the first place?
I have to be honest and say what drew me to it was the pretty hat. But once I started competing, I realized that my validation didn't come from a crown. It came from who I was inside and who God called me to be.
And what type of advice would you give to young girls out there who are looking at Charity and saying, I want to be just like you?
You can, you will, trust God, because He will too.
Where do you think your future is going to take you now?
Well, I'm hopefully about to start on my rap career and take off with that. You know, I've been really passionate about my music for years, but I haven't been able to post my music because of the Miss America organization. I didn't want any backlash from it. So now I'm ready to go full-fledged. And now that I see that it's accepted, I'm so ready. I'm excited.
Well, I just wanted to impress upon you, the crowd was so with you tonight. You must have felt that
a little bit. Yes, ma'am. I felt it tremendously. And that's another reason why I'm so emotional, because out of all the years that I've competed, I remember my parents not being able to be here in the crowd and having small claps here and there, to hearing the whole crowd just roar your name. It's overwhelming, and I couldn't be more thankful.
Wow, you just made the top five at Miss Mississippi. How do you feel?
So surreal. I kept thinking back to 13-year-old Caitlin competing in the Outstanding Teen Pageant, and I know that she would be so proud of me. This is an absolute dream come true.
Tell us, what got you here?
Well, I started competing in the Miss Mississippi organization when I was just 12 years old. And so it's been a very long journey of growth and gaining confidence and skills and a lot of hard work and determination, honestly.
What phase of competition do you think you excelled in to make it into the five?
Well, probably my favorite portion of competition, which is talent. I've been singing since before I could really talk, and it's always been my favorite. It's the one that I put the most time and effort into, and I think that because I go out there and I just press play because I work so hard at it, that it always pays off for me.
Well, I know that when you were up there in the 10, what did you feel like when they called you into the five?
Disbelief. I was not expecting to hear my name be called, but I was so, so thankful.
Top five at Miss Mississippi. How are you feeling right now?
I'm so overwhelmed with joy. This is a dream come true for me, and I'm absolutely just amazed.
What do you think helped to get you up into the top five here?
Not thinking about it. You really didn't have time to think about anything, and just going with my gut and how I prepared, and really just going on autopilot.
Well, what would you give as advice to a young girl who wants to be where you are right now?
I would say keep going. I started as a shy 15-year-old girl in the Miss Mississippi's Outstanding Teen Pageant, and here I am 7 years later at 21 years old, a confident young woman, and got top five at Miss Mississippi. So I would just say keep going and be confident in who you are and show who you are, because you shine no matter what.
What quality in yourself do you feel has improved so much over the years of competing?
Definitely confidence. Like I said, I was a shy 15-year-old girl, and now I'm just a confident young woman who would put herself on the Miss Mississippi stage twirling and talking, and I would never have imagined that for myself.
How are you feeling right now?
It is just, it's such an honor. You know, you always come with a certain dream of what you want to accomplish, but you never know if that's actually going to happen. And so to be given this honor once again, to be in the top five at Miss Mississippi, I just feel so privileged and humbled.
What qualities in yourself do you feel have improved over competing at Miss Mississippi?
I think my intentionality is so important, that as a Miss Mississippi, as a local title holder, and just as Vivian, that I am being intentional with every single person that I come into contact with. And I've been given so many opportunities through this organization to continue doing that and cultivating that skill. And that's something that is lifelong and not just in the pageant world.
What do you think propelled you into the five?
I think it's exactly what we just talked about. You know, I talked about up here during the top five question about my love of storytelling and how I think it's so important. And so I think it was my ability to tell my story and be true to myself. And hopefully the judges saw authentic Vivian.
How have the scholarship dollars that you've gotten, like tonight and before, what have they meant in your life?
So very much. I have been involved in this organization for years, and I graduated with an undergraduate degree, with a bachelor's degree, completely debt-free, and I'm currently working on my second degree, my master's of education in higher education, and I haven't paid a dime so far, and that's thanks to the Miss America organization.
Congratulations, Emmy. Please take your first walk as Miss Mississippi.
Thank you all so much for joining us for Miss Mississippi 2022.